Let's see how they stack up. Kelly is 1 year older and 1 centimeter shorter. There's 100 grams in it. So these two really are pretty close in all of the stats. This is the Philippines against Australia. That's Emily Chu. And this is our main event of the evening, featuring Rob Lasita and Eric Kelly. This fight is brought to you by AMC Live Group. And a fast start from Lasita, who goes banging with both hands, knees to the body from both men.
Yeah, can't say we're surprised. We knew that Rob was going to come out of here fast and furious. And Eric's doing a good job of nullifying it and just weathering that storm. A lot of dirty boxing going on in the first 15, 20 seconds. And this fight has massive title implications. Whoever comes out of the winner here could easily be right next in line for that featherweight crack at the belt.
Certainly, Lasita thinks that's next in line for him if he wins this.
I would imagine Eric also feels the same way. Now, Lasita's in on that single leg and really just kind of trying to muscle it through, looking for a front guillotine. He's really just muscling Eric Kelly.
He looks the bigger man, doesn't he, Lasita?
He does. He definitely does. And I think he's stronger, obviously. I mean, Eric's much more of a precise striker, but got to be careful of the knees on the head here. Now, that's a deep guillotine choke. Yeah, that's really deep. This is going to be interesting to see if Eric Kelly can defend from here. Oh, Rob just let it go.
Looked like he was in a really good position there, didn't it, for a while?
It looked deep. Oh, almost had that throw, that judo throw there. Just didn't pop his hips enough to go all the way through with it. Eric's got to be careful. Keeps getting his head snapped down there by Lasita, and he's going to eat some knees.
It's a lot of pressure that Kelly's had on his neck in the minute and a half of this contest that we've had.
Yep. I mean, Rob Lasita has just been muscling Eric Kelly all over the place.
Oh, what a nice kick. Yeah.
Rob Lasita's been calling for this fight, too, before he signed with 1FC. He said, I want to fight Eric Kelly. And after his first win, he said, I wanted Eric Kelly. And I'm interested to see why that was. I mean, obviously, Eric Kelly was one of the most highly talked about prospects. And Eric has a complete bag of tricks. This is that front choke. This is tight on the neck of Eric Kelly.
Kelly bleeding from the nose.
This is kind of a funky choke, though, because some guys will tap from that, and some guys, it's just really uncomfortable.
Takes a knee to the head, the Filipino. Lasita just looks the stronger man when they're body to body like this and gripping each other, and Kelly's neck has been under so much strain. Nice hands from Kelly, a left and a right.
Well, Eric Kelly just throws nice 1-2 combinations. Oh, and he got caught with that left.
It was a heavy punch. Oh, and the swinging right.
You know, I almost said that this is the first 1FC we've gone through without getting
a shot in the baby button.
And man, I didn't want to jinx us. I thought about that, but
we were almost there.
So close to being a non-groin-struck 1FC event. But Rob Lasita will get up to 5 minutes if he needs it. That was clearly unintentional. Eric's arguably one of the nicest guys you're ever going to meet outside of the cage. And that left hook, and Rob just wants to plant and exchange punches. Eric's a little more of an outside boxer. And that really messes up the rhythm, too. If you're a pinpoint striker like Eric likes to be, when a guy's constantly pressuring and he's in your face, you have to rely on counter-striking. You can't really set your punches up as much as you'd like to. It disrupts your rhythm.
Well within the 5 minutes that he was allowed, Rob Lasita gets back into this one.
Another nice takedown by Rob. Caught that kick. Now we've seen Eric work off his back before. Oh, he's looking for a heel hook. This is dangerous positions for both men because, you know, this is like almost a 50-50. Rob's got that leg in deep and he's hooking that. Eric's fishing for some legs. He wants to either untangle Rob's feet or start attacking at his feet.
Oh, he had to let go because he was getting brutalized to the face, Lasita. And now Kelly.
Oh, just missed the back. Overshot it by about 4 or 5 inches.
It's a cracking contest.
Is a cracker it is.
Minute and 10 left.
Eric is very active off his back. See, and there's that sweat plays a huge factor. A nice work by Eric, keeping nice pressure on Rob, using that head. Oh, you see Eric going for the back again. He feels that neck. You know, one of the things I like about how Eric Kelly takes the back is that you don't necessarily need to have your hooks in first. As we've seen before, if you feel that neck exposed, you can just throw your arm in there and sink it like the Titanic.
Now then.
That's not deep enough. But man, Eric Kelly sticking on Rob Lucido like Velcro.
And he's really come back into this contest because he was under the cosh for the first couple of minutes or so.
Oh, Rob just grazes the chin of Eric Kelly.
Big props to Kelly for working his way back into this contest. It looked for a while as if Lucido was just simply stronger.
Oh, and he just hit him with a nice short right hook.
Second time in the last minute that Lucido just cuffs Eric Kelly around the jaw as they pull out.
Oh, ruthless, was just absolutely ruthless. Eric just missed that hip throw, but Rob has been all over Eric on the ground just with a barrage of strikes. Kicks, punches, knees. You see here, he looked for the submission. It really wasn't deep enough. A couple of spots where Eric jumped on Rob's back too. Unintentional groin strike. And you see here the ankle lock. Rob's been very active with looking for submissions and positions. And Eric also hopped on Rob's back a few times. Rob looks like he's breathing a little heavier than he should be just for the first round here. It's one of the tolls you pay when you're that aggressive. Eric, much fresher.
Red corner, seconds out, please. Red corner, seconds out.
The red corner getting a bit of a telling off from Lenny Hart there. Get out quickly, boys. We're eager for the action. Very entertaining first round. Lucido had the early going. Kelly had the later going.
Well, Rob looks a little bit more tired here. But man, you wouldn't know it by the way he's winging those punches.
Both of them swinging early on as they were in the initial moments of the first round. And Rob's got Eric's back.
He does, it that looks, oh, he's bleeding like a sieve from the nose. Now, what would you say so far in that first round, Mr. Rich Franklin, as far as aggression goes?
It's been quite a bit back and forth, really even. They both had a little bit of ground control, landed some effective strikes, but in this case, I'm going to give the first round so far to Lucido through aggression.
Yeah, the aggression so far through the first 5 minutes has definitely been Lucido, and it looks like there is a faucet opened up and it's bleeding ketchup.
Really tremendous amount of blood on the canvas
there. Yeah, that's a lot. That could be a broken nose when you separate, like a deviated septum or you break your nose. Those will just stream blood. I imagine that Yuji's going to have to stop this here just to double check on it, but he doesn't want to stop it when Rob's in such an advantageous position. You see Yuji just looked up. We have,
Oh, wow.
Eric Kelly, he caught Rob sleeping.
Kelly just pulled this one out of the bag.
Wow, that was craziness.
Doesn't look as if he wants to go for it. Yuji wants to have a look at that face, and he's, oh, wow. It's just in a really bad way.
Well, it could just be a bloody nose. I mean, you know, you take a little bit of blood, it looks like an absolute massacre, but, you know, Eric Kelly definitely caught Lucido sleeping there. He jumped on his back.
He's trying to see if it's an internal injury or external on the nose. There is a little mark on the exterior of the nose, but, yeah, it's almost certainly broken, isn't it?
Yeah, I would imagine with bleeding that much, broken noses. And, you know, one of the intangibles, too, when a nose breaks, all that blood goes down the back of your throat, and you have a mouthpiece in, so your breathing is already restricted.
Breathing's a nightmare, yeah.
Yeah, Thiago Alves kicked my butt and broke my nose, and man, I just remember thinking, like, this is what breathing feels like. I don't remember it ever being this uncomfortable, you know, and that just really, it just hinders tremendously. You know, Rob Lucido's slow to get up, too. I'm a little concerned as to what's going on. Rob's still sitting down in the center of the cage. We got a shot here of Eric Kelly. See here, Rob, this doesn't look
and he's breathing hard as well as he was in between rounds, Rob Lucida.
Yeah, and I can't tell if he's hanging out there from an injury or if he's just kind of taking his time because he's a little fatigued, but slow to get up either way.
He doesn't look comfortable. He's getting a good mopping down because he's obviously swathed in blood.
I think Rob wants to start back on the ground.
Ah, that's what he's going for, is it? Yeah, okay.
So, I guess it's Yuji's call on this one. And it's like a college wrestling match. Well, you know, that's pretty close to where it was, too, because I even think that Eric Kelly may have had a deeper hook in, but you could say, yeah, the nose is definitely broken on Eric Kelly. It's dripping a lot. And all that extra blood and sweat. It's going to be a slip fest.
Oh, good kick from Lucida. Looking towards that face that has already suffered so much damage from the Filipino.
Well, Eric Kelly is a warrior, if nothing else. And on a nice leg trip. And Lucida, just great job of staying on top.
The canvas is pretty slippery there. And that's going to be an issue.
Absolutely. I mean, that could really be a hindrance in throwing kicks and things, too. And just this is where cardio plays such a gargantuan factor because you lose so much of your hold on your grip on your opponent for submissions and for other things. You know, it really just becomes constantly being able to push and pull and move and roll with the punches. Here the corner, Rob Lucida saying, just make him bleed more and just keep working on it. Keep attacking where he's weak. I think that's a chapter out of Art of War, isn't it?
The corner asking for short elbows. Anything that goes in the area of the nose is going to be a problem, but knees to the nose are really heavy, heavy blows.
Yeah, and strategically too, Lucida, if he keeps working on the nose of Eric Kelly, that may be enough for Yuji to stop the fight.
Yeah.
Whether or not Eric Kelly wants the fight stopped, so staying busy on that's definitely not a bad idea.
Well, you can see the extent of the damage just by looking at the canvas beneath Eric Kelly.
Oh, Eric Kelly moves his way into half mount. Again, man, this is just what we talk about, back and forth. This is so fatiguing. It's like a game of human twister. Left hand canvas, right arm choke.
Well, it's so slippery in there for these two, mainly because of the blood. But towards the end of the second round here, there's a lot of perspiration as well. Lucida does look tired.
Well, it's been a frantic pace, and you know, Eric Kelly, he's got that choke in deep. This could be a very bad spot for Rob if he's not able to peel Eric Kelly's hands off.
What a turnaround. You know, you can do
that. That is really deep, and it's over! Eric Kelly with the triumphant return.
And look how distraught Rob Lucida is.
Oh, Rob is just absolutely devastated by this loss, but man, you cannot take this away from him. Look at Eric Kelly.
I think both men could be in tears, Jason. Lucida is absolutely beside himself, but Kelly has come back from a position where the fight could have been stopped at any moment due to that horrific nose injury.
Eric Kelly just headhunting too, back and forth, so many rear naked choke attempts, and finally Eric punched the right ticket. You
just
take a look here.
Did not give up.
Yeah, I mean, we take a look here at the action, and it was just a rock'em sock'em robot contest, a tremendous amount of blood, and that's where you saw Eric Kelly just found Rob Lucida sleeping a little bit and jumped on his back. And then this beautiful outside leg trip, and then Rob just did a spectacular job of rolling with it and getting back up. Back and forth. Just a crazy amount of action. And it was just an even fight all the way through. And then finally, you see, he doesn't even have the hooks in there. That's Marcelo Garcia 101. You see a neck, you go for it. Start choking if it's in deep enough.
Both of those men, you could see, absolutely spent at the end of that. And Eric Kelly has just engineered himself right back into title contention. I wonder if a rematch with Honorio Bonario is perhaps in their future. Or will he go straight to the title shot?
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Yuji Shimada calls a halt to this battle at 3 minutes, 43 seconds of round number two for your winner via submission by rear naked choke, Eric the Natural Killer!